Hello everyone, this is Blender Guppy. In this video, I'll be discussing the grid project operator found in Random Flow and Creative Flow. Unlike Quad Slice, which creates cuts from vertices, the grid project operator simply projects grid cuts on a face or faces regardless of the surrounding topology. Its main purpose is to quickly fill a face or faces with quad topology. This makes it easier to model extra details on ingon faces that would otherwise take too long to quantify. The generated grid topology can be temporary until you have modeled something from it, or can be used to some extent to quad repair parts of the mesh. This is also used with random flow since the randomizations only works with quad faces. In the redo panel, we first have the center property. Average means the grid will be projected to the average or mean position of all the faces selected, and per face will project the grid per individual faces in the selection. We have the direction property, which, like in quad slice, also determines the direction of the cuts in the XY axis. Tangent, of course, means the direction of the longest edge in the face. You can cycle through them using the tangent property to select the correct alignment. Edge means the direction of the face edges in the selection, which you can cycle through using the edge property below. Then we have the view, which uses the viewport orientation for the XY direction of the cuts. We have the geometry property, which determines which part of the mesh is affected by the cuts. Selected only affects the selected faces. Linked faces affects only the faces that are linked to the selected faces or the face island, and all faces means the cuts will affect the entire mesh. Next, we have the cuts property, which determines the number of cuts in the XY axis. You can switch the cuts amount from uniform to individual, so you can individually set the number of cuts for the X and Y axis. The offset property can be used to offset the XY axis cuts in its forward and backward directions. And the size property determines the size of the projected grid. The rotation property, much like in quad slice, rotates the cuts. If the direction property fails to provide the right alignment, then you can use rotate to adjust the cut's orientation. Meanwhile, the triangulate ingots toggle will triangulate the ingot faces generated in the grid projection. This mostly happens in the border areas where the original topology of the faces selected are located. The distance property works the same as quad slice. The cut lines generated will be removed or merged depending on its distance threshold from the neighboring topology. This is a great way of removing nearly zero area faces that can sometimes result in the grid projection. Using it with quad slice can also help you fully quantify some faces. The main difference between Creative Flow's grid project and random flow is the proc and seed properties. This randomizes the possibility of whether the lines in that particular grid location will be created using a percentage property. The lower the percentage, the lower the chance a certain line will be cut. You can cycle through different iterations using the seed property. Its main purpose is to quickly create a random quad topology for the randomization operators in random flow to work on. And that's it for this video. If you have any questions, be sure to use the comments section below or the links in the description. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.